Good morning, dear friends. In last lecture, we started with second chapter under general pharmacology, that is routes of administration of the drug. In last lecture, we completed up to enteral route, that is oral, sublingual, and rectal. Now, from today, we start with the second type under routes of administration, that is parenteral route of administration. Now, parenteral, already you know that this word is derived from Greek word, that is par. Par means beyond, and enteral. Enteral means intestine. Means parenteral route where then the administration of the drug occurs beyond intestine or beyond gastrointestinal tract. Drug directly reaches into blood or enter into the systemic circulation. That route of administration is called as parenteral route of administration. Generally, the drugs in the form of solutions and suspensions given by the parenteral route of administration. Whatever the drugs given by parenteral route, there should be strict aseptic conditions should be maintained during manufacturing of the drugs, and even during administration of the drug, strict aseptic or sterile conditions are going to be needed. The main advantages of this parenteral route of administration, that whatever the drug given by parenteral route, by any route, that is by injections, inhalation, intophoresis or inoxia, whatever the case, here the drug produces fast onset of action as compared to oral route of administration, and therefore this route is useful in emergency patients also. Parenteral route, as if you compare with oral route, that it produces fast onset of action as compared to oral route, and therefore useful in emergency patients also. In addition to this, another advantage of parenteral route, that this parenteral route effective if the patient become unconscious and uncooperative. See that whatever the disadvantages of oral route, in opposite meaning you supposed to be remember advantages of parenteral route. So this parenteral route effective in unconscious and uncooperative patient. That patient wishes the self, uncooperative self, that is sudha upon parenteral and drug fusion to. Even this route effective if the patient suffering from vomiting and diarrhea. Vomiting and diarrhea also. Those drugs destroyed by GIT or by gastrointestinal tract, or those drugs having first pass metabolism, that is directly reaches at the site of liver, such a drug should not be given by oral route but given by parenteral route. Isn't it? Even another thing, that accurate concentration of the drug. Accurate concentration of the drug can be achieved by means of parenteral route of administration. So these are the advantages or merits of parenteral route. Another point, that is disadvantages or demerits. Now here you just remember that whatever the advantages of oral route, that in opposite meaning there is a disadvantage. Suppose in case of parenteral route, that this route is not convenient, not economical to the patient. This is because it requires skill, it requires technique for administration. Another disadvantage, that self-medication of the drug is difficult. In case of parenteral route, patient may not be administered self-medicament. That is, self-medication is difficult. While in case of oral route, self-medication is going to be possible. It requires strict aseptic or strict condition, sterile conditions or aseptic condition. During manufacturing, even during administration of the drug, sterile condition or aseptic conditions are going to be required. In addition to this, another disadvantage of parenteral route, that there may be chances of abscesses or pus formation at the site of injection. If there is a proper skin may not be maintained, then there is a chances of abscesses, pain, inflammation may occur at the site of joint. So these are what? These are the disadvantages of parenteral route. In most of the time, they may be asked, what is parenteral route? Mention its advantages and disadvantages for PMR. So you supposed to remember that whatever the disadvantages of oral route, in opposite meaning, there is the advantages of parenteral route. Why? Whatever the advantages of oral route, In opposite meaning, there is a disadvantage. So this is parental root of administration. Now this parental root divided into four types. We already completed under classification that first type, that is injection, second one inhalation, third anaphoresis, and fourth one is inoction. Now let us see first type, that is injections. Now under injections, let us see first type, that is intradermal route of administration. First type of under injection, that is intradermal IV. Here administration of drug occurs between layer of skin, that is dermis and epidermis layer. Dermis and epidermis layer, within layer of skin when drug injected, that route of administration is called as intradermal route of administration. Generally this route is useful for detection of allergy of the drug. Suppose penicillin allergy detection, this penicillin allergy detection occurs by this route of administration, where drug injected between layer of skin, that is dermis and epidermis layer. Even vaccines, toxoid preparations, generally given by intradermal route of administration. And the maximum quantity of liquid medicament given by this route should not be greater than 0.2 ml. Just after here route 0.2 ml drug due shop. That route of administration, that is called as intradermal. Intradermal means within the layer of the skin, dermis and epidermis layer. And therefore this route is called as intradermal route of administration. Then second type, which is important as far as your annual examination concerned, that is intramuscular route of administration, IM. Intramuscular, how to remember, what is intramuscular route? Where drug injected into the deep muscles, that route of administration, that is called as intramuscular route. Where drug injected into the deeper muscles, that route of administration, that is intramuscular route of administration. Generally, this route useful for oily injectable preparations. Those drugs having oily injectable vehicles, even collider particles, suspended particulate matter, such a type of the injectable preparations given by intramuscular route of administration. Those drugs having oily injectable vehicle preparations, some injectable preparations contain collider particulate matter or suspended particulate matter, such a drug mostly given by intramuscular route of administration. And the maximum quantity of liquid, that is injectable preparation given, is not more than 10 ml. Just upon intramuscular route, 10 ml paksha jaasti injection deu shakat nahi. That route of administration, that is intramuscular route of administration. So here what is the advantage? That this route effective for oily injectable preparation. These drugs should not be given by any other route. Given only by intramuscular route of administration. Oily injectable vehicle preparation, even collider particulate matter, suspended particulate matter injections given by this route of administration. Another advantage, that it produces rapid and uniform absorption of the drug. There is a rapid and uniform absorption of this drug take place by this route. Only the disadvantage, that this route effective only, that is not more than 10 ml of injection given by this route. Another disadvantage, that might be written hypertonic solutions also should not be given by this route. One more disadvantage, that high molecular weight substances or those drugs, if you compare with oral route, in some drug category like diazepam injections, phenytoin injections, require more time for absorption as compared to oral route. Suppose if you give the diazepam or phenytoin injectable preparations and tablet formulation, there is a, it needs more time for absorption as compared to oral route. That is the disadvantage of intramuscular route of administration. So sometimes you may ask that, mention what is intramuscular route, mention advantages and disadvantages. Then another type under injection, which is important one, that is intramuscular route of administration. Sorry, intravenous route of administration. First we completed intradermal, second intramuscular, and third one is intravenous route of administration. That is, we called as IV route of administration. Generally, the liquid medicaments like mild irritants, hypertonic solutions, isotonic solutions, generally given by intravenous route of administration. Where drug injected into the orbital vein, that route of administration, their drug directly mixed, directly entered into the blood, and therefore that route of administration is called as intravenous route of administration. The specific advantages of intravenous route, that it produces very fast onset of action, very fast onset of action as compared to other routes of administration. Within 15 seconds it produces its pharmacological action. As directly drug enters into the blood, it produces very fast, and therefore intravenous route effective in most emergency patients also. So the first advantage of this route, that it produces very fast onset of action. Within 15 seconds it produces its onset of action. Another advantage of intravenous route, that large volume of solution can be injected by this route. आपण बघतो की saliva ते saliva injection ला देऊ शकतो. In case of intramuscular, not more than 10 ml, but in intravenous, large volume of solution, 500 ml saline solution, 1 liter solution given injected through intravenous route. Means large volume of solution given by this route of administration. Another advantage, that by this route drug produces 100% bioavailability. Bioavailability, that is whatever the concentration injected by intravenous route, same concentration of the drug found in blood also. Bioavailability, that is nothing but availability of the drug after complete absorption into the blood or enter into systemic circulation, that concentration, that is bioavailability. Suppose if one drug by 100 milligram injection given by intravenous route of administration, it shows 100% bioavailability, same concentration present in blood. Same drug if given in tablet form containing 500 milligram drug, but may process 400 milligram concentration in blood, means produces 80% bioavailability by oral route. But same drug when given by intravenous route, it produces 100% bioavailability, 100% concentration available in blood. Another advantage of intravenous route, that very small concentration, minute concentration of the drug also be effective by this route of administration. 0.1 milligram, that concentration of the drug given by intravenous route, it produces pharmacological action. Means very minute concentration, very small concentration of the drug also effective by this route of administration. These are what? These are the advantages. But what are the disadvantages of intravenous route? That first thing, that those drug precipitating blood constituents, such a drug should not be given by intravenous route of administration. Right? Because that is a blood constituent that precipitate corruption. Or some drug, those drug causes hemolysis, such a drug also should not be given by intravenous route of administration. Another thing, that speed of the drug entered into the vein must be controlled. You know that whatever the saline solution given through IV set, where there is a drop by drop, but speed of the solution should be maintained to enter into the blood, that it should be proper. Otherwise there may be chances of lingering effect may occur in patient. So speed of the drug should be maintained by intravenous route of administration. Another disadvantage, that if proper care is not taken, then there is a chances of inflammation or maybe abscesses or pus formation may take place at the site of injection. आपण बऱ्याचदा बघतो की सलाइन वापरताना जर प्रॉपर केअर नाही घेतली गेली, देर मे चान्सेस ऑफ पेन, इन्फ्लॅमेशन, एब्सेसेस और पस फॉर्मेशन मे ऑकर. सो यू सपोज टू रिमेंबर दीज आर एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ इंट्रावेनस. दिस इज ऑल्सो मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट क्वेश्चन एज फार एज एन्युअल एंड सेक्शनल एग्जाम टू कन्सर्न. फॉर थ्री एंड अ पास यू आस्क टू क्वेश्चन, दैट वॉट इज इंट्रावेनस रूट, वॉट आर द एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस. इवन अनदर important point under injection, that is subcutaneous route of administration. So intradermal, intramuscular, intravenous and fourth one is subcutaneous. These four are important in annual examination. So fourth one, that is called as subcutaneous route of administration. Subcutaneous route, that is also called as hypodermic process. Hypodermic process. Now what is subcutaneous route? Sub means below. Sub means below and cutaneous means skin, where administration of the drug occurs below the skin. जेव्हा स्किनच्या खाली आपण ड्रग इंजेक्ट करतो, that route of administration, that is called as subcutaneous route of administration. Generally, the drugs like insulin injection, you know that insulin, that is using diabetes related situation. Insulin injection. Even certain hormonal preparations are given by this route of administration. Only non-irritant drugs. Non-irritant drugs are effective by this route of administration. Generally, you know that insulin injections in diabetes patient injected below the skin. Only non-irritant drugs effective by this route of administration. Just like insulin preparations, hormonal preparations generally given by subcutaneous route. That is, sub is below the skin, where drug injected below the skin, and therefore that route of administration that is called as subcutaneous route of administration. There are three processes under subcutaneous route. One that is to be called as the hypodermolysis process. Second one that is called as the jet injection or hypospray method. And third method that is called as implants, that is depot formulation. Under subcutaneous, there are three types. One is the hypodermolysis process. Second, jet injection or hypospray method. And second one that is called as implants or depot formulation. Now what is hypodermolysis? This is the special process of injecting large amount of the drug below the skin. Large amount of the drug, particularly in children, when there is a, or even in mass inoculation program, this hypodermolysis process is going to be chosen. Where drug directly injected in large quantity at the site of eyes or at the site of buttocks, that route of administration that is called as hypodermolysis. Even in children or even in old age people, most of the time it is very difficult to find out the vein. When puncturing is going to be difficult. In that condition, generally this route of administration is preferred, that is called as hypodermolysis process. Second one, jet injection or hypospray method. In this method, drug injected through jet, through small microfine orifice, and under high velocity, drug directly injected below the skin. This method is devoid of needle and therefore it is painless. But under high velocity jet, this through my small microfine orifice, drug directly injected below the skin, that method that is called as jet injection or hypospray method. And third process, third method, that is implants or depot formulation. The advantage of sustained action, long duration of action obtained through the implant or through depot, where generally hormonal preparations, tablets kept below the skin, slowly dissolve, slowly release into the blood and produces long action, sustained action, that route of administration that is to be called as implant or depot formulation. So these are the three types under subcutaneous and hypodermolysis process, jet injection or hypospray method, and third one is implant or depot. So these four first injections, that is intradermal route, intramuscular, subcutaneous and intravenous, these four are very important. While in remaining time, you are supposed to remember the definition, that is, you know that intra-articular route of administration. Just you know the definition, intra-articular, where the drug injected at the site of joint. The joint chain, that is even drug will be. For example, particularly hydrocortisone injection. This hydrocortisone injection useful in rheumatoid arthritis. Sandhivala mein jo hydrocortisone injection deta, that route that is generally given at the site of joint. That route of administration that is called as intra-articular route of administration. Another definition, intracardia, where drug directly injected at the site of heart under extreme emergency condition, that route of administration that is called as intracardia route of administration. Another definition, that is intrathecal route of administration. Intrathecal, then intraparitoneal. Intraparitoneal, where drug injected directly into the peritoneal cavity. While intraspinal, that is where drug injected into the spinal cord. That is directly under extreme emergency condition or under strict aseptic condition, directly drug injected, that route of administration, that is to be of a intrathecal, intraspinal type of route of administration. So, in remaining time, you are supposed to remember the definition. My four are very important, or mentioned advantages and disadvantages of parenteral route, or these four, that is intravenous, intramuscular, subcutaneous and intradermal. These four are important ones. While in some cases you remember the definition. So this is the first type under parenteral route, that is injection. Now the second type under parenteral route, that is inhalation route of administration. This is the first injections, then second type, that is called as inhalation route of administration. Now inhalation, you already know that generally nowadays, particularly bronchial asthma patient, those having chest problem, in that patient generally the drug given by inhalation route of administration. Generally drug in the form of vapors, even atomizers are going to be available, various type of the atomizers, spray are going to be available for inhalation. You know that salbutamol spray, a standing spray available in market for inhalation purpose. Respules are going to be available in market, generally inhaled by the patient, and this drug directly entered into the respiratory tract and then entered into the blood. The main advantage of this route of administration, that volatile concentration of substances maintained through inhalation route of administration. Generally nitrogens, oxygens, even chloroform, diethyl ether, such a volatile substances generally given by inhalation. Even nowadays, so many drugs are used in bronchial asthma, given by inhalation, by spray method. Even minute droplets spread through the vapors and inhaled by the patient, that produces action. Only the drawback, that those drug produces toxic effect at the site of respiratory tract, or those drug produces infection at the time of site of respiratory tract, such a drug should not be given by inhalation route of administration. Generally, oxygen, various medicinal gases, then chloroform, these drug detectable, these preparations generally given by inhalation. Then third type, antophoresis. Antophoresis, actually this question will not be repeated in exam, but you should know that antophoresis, this is the method where through galvanic current, drug penetrated to deeper tissue, into the deeper tissue, that route of administration, that is to be called as antophoresis method, where anode antophoresis and cathode antophoresis available. Generally, anode antophoresis used for drugs bearing positive charges, while cathode antophoresis used for drugs bearing negative charges. And the force of repulsion between similar charges made that drive the drug to enter into the deeper tissue. So that route of administration, that is called as antophoresis, through galvanic current, drug entered to the deeper tissue. And last fourth one, under parenteral route, that is inhalation. Inhalation, where drugs applied locally to the skin, rub on the skin, and produces systemic effect. Therefore, that route of administration is called as inhalation route. For example, cod liver oil. You know that this cod liver oil to the scalded skin is going to be applied. Well, rub on the skin, enter into the blood, produces systemic effect, and therefore this would classify under parenteral route, that is called as inhalation route of administration. So these are the four types under parenteral: injection, inhalation, antophoresis, and inhalation. Now the last type under routes of administration, that is local or topical route of administration. This is the last type, that is local or topical route of administration. As the name itself indicating, that generally the drugs applied locally or topically, various formulations like ointment, paste, creams, jellies, powders, snuffs, generally given by these route of administration. That route of administration, that is called as local or topical. This is the very simplest mode of administration of the drug. Generally, the drugs applied to the ear, nose, throat, even rectum, vagina, that route of administration, that is to be called as local or topical route of administration. Generally, the main disadvantage of this route, that if the drug containing watery solution, this watery solution may penetrate to the skin and that may process side effect. That is only the problem. But if you compare with other routes, again, this is the very simplest mode of administration of the drug. That is called as local or topical route of administration. So this is third type, and we will finish second chapter, that is rules of administration of drugs. So already along with this, notes are also provided to you. You just click on the link and write down the notes, complete the first chapter notes, and even today you complete second chapter, that is rules of administration. Next time we start with the third chapter, that is general pharmacology, that is pharmacokinetic. Thank you.